If it's all right to speak candidly, I found this very curious from the start. We don't fully understand why this trial is being held in this court in the first place.
What do you mean?
What?
To begin, let's look at the defendants. Who are these defendants we're speaking of?
Do you not see that the defendants are right there?
Equipment. Meaning you're prosecuting property as citizens. Let's use a gun as an example of equipment. A gun does not shoot a being on its own. A being is the one who pulls the trigger. In that case, it is the being who should be tried and not the gun. Wouldn't you agree with that? Why would you ever charge the equipment over the being using it? When do you plan to charge the Foreign Affairs Clan? Does this not call into question the prosecution's sanity? It is hard to understand how they can so brazenly commit an aggravated breach of trust against the civil service clan and insult this court! Plus, it's a waste of public funds.
Order in the court!
So, on this 15th day of what is considered to be the most important trial of the day, Johnny Cochran has appeared to defend Capitalist Records. The question now is, will Cochran use his famous Chewbacca defense?
Ladies and gentlemen of the supposed jury, Chef's attorney would certainly want you to believe that his client wrote Stinky Britches 10 years ago. And they make a good case. Hell, I almost felt pity myself. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Chewbacca. Chewbacca is a Wookiee from the planet Kishik. But Chewbacca lives on the planet Endor. Now think about that. That does not make sense. But more importantly, you have to ask yourself, what does this have to do with this case? Nothing. Ladies and gentlemen, it has nothing to do with this case. It does not make sense. If Chewbacca lives on Endor, you must acquit. The defense rests.
Okay, then.